Hey everyone, in today's video, we're going to look at how we can install firmware and applications on the Flipper Zero. I'm going to be using Kali Linux, but the directions for Windows are similar and I'll mention any differences. Many people use flipc.org to install applications, but it's been under maintenance lately. So in this video, we'll learn how to build and deploy Flipper application packages, FAPs, ourselves. Let's get started. If all you need is the latest firmware, using a web installer is the easiest method. Head over to lab.flipper.net, click on My Flipper, choose which branch you want, such as Release, Release Candidate, or Dev. Dev has the latest changes but may not be as stable, and then just click the Install button. If you prefer Rogue Master, over on GitHub, click Releases, and then choose Web Installer. And now we'll have the Rogue Master firmware shown and we can click Install. On Extreme Firmware, you can click on Releases and then choose Web Updater Chrome. And this loads their own installer. And then here you can choose which version you want. It'll default to the latest and then click the Flash button. If you prefer Unleashed, go to Releases, scroll down the page, and you'll see a feature set that describes the different versions. You can choose things such as the version R, which is if you have the RGB or the version for the extra apps. So we'll go ahead and click the extra apps, which is the E version. And you can see it's Unleash 071E. And then you can click the install button. So I forgot to mention that your browser needs to be a Chrome-based browser. So Chrome or Microsoft Edge, one of those kind of browsers, will be able to use the APIs to talk to your Flipper Zero. The install will take a couple of minutes. So in this video, I'm going to go ahead and just speed up the video. Once it's copied the files to your Flipper screen will also show some updating messages. And then eventually it'll show this screen once it's been fully updated. If the app you want is part of the official store, you can go to lab.flipper.net/apps and then choose the area like games or tools. And then you can scroll down to the game, click on the tile. You'll see information like the description and changelog, the repository where the GitHub is, and then you can click install to install the application. This may work for custom firmware as well, or you may get an API mismatch when you try to run the application. If the app isn't in the store or the store version doesn't work with your firmware, you can try building your own copy from source code. In this video, I'm using Kali Linux, but the steps are very similar for Windows. The only required tool we have is the Get Tools, and you can go here and click on your OS to download it. There's also probably a button that's auto-detected for your OS. In Kali Linux, it's already pre-installed, so we don't need that. In this version, we're using FBT, but if you're using the micro FBT, then you'll also need to install a version of Python. So you can click on the Download Python and install that. And we're just using the command line today, but if you wanted to use Visual Studio Code, which has a nice editor, you would click on Download. And you can choose which operating system you want, as well as which particular installer, if you need a particular installer. So once you've installed the prerequisites for your operating system, you're going to go ahead and open a command terminal. In Windows, this is called the command prompt. So just hit the Windows key and type command prompt. In Kali, it's a terminal emulator. And then we'll go ahead and make a directory where we're going to store all of our files from GitHub, and then we'll switch into that directory. For step three, you're going to want to choose the command associated with the firmware you want to run on your Flipper Zero. So in my case, I'm doing unleashed, so I'll copy this get command, paste that into the command window, and press enter. And that'll take a few minutes while it downloads all of the files from the repo. And then next you're going to want to change directory into the directory you just created. So that's the next command. And then we're going to choose which branch we want to run. So you can choose a release branch if you want stability, or dev branch if you want the newest features. This next step is totally optional, but if you have Visual Studio Code, I recommend running FBT VS Code underscore dist. Make sure that you put the dot slash in front of it if you're in Kali, and in Windows, make sure you don't put the dot slash. I recommend you back up any files that you care about on your SD card, and then make sure your flipper is not running any applications, QFlipper's not running, and that it's plugged into your computer. I've gone ahead and sped up this part of the video. If you get a fatal error, kill signal terminated, go ahead and run the command again. And again. I'm not sure why I had to run it a couple times. Normally it works the first time. This time the error says I forgot to plug in my flipper. So plug in your flipper and run the command again. And now it's downloading that custom firmware onto our flipper. And then on our flipper, you can see it's updated. The cloning, building, and deploying steps actually took my computer about 20 minutes total. So now that our flipper is running our firmware, let's look at how we could run a custom app. So for this one, we'll look at this Flipper Zero application that somebody told us about. So the question is, where can we find this application? So one thing we can do is just go to Google and search for it and see what it says. You could check Discord or Facebook posts or whatever and see if anybody has a link to the GitHub where this project is. Rogue Master actually has a ton of apps, so a lot of times I'll just search their README and see if I can find the app. And this link goes to the same GitHub. So we could use that GitHub as our source, but a lot of times I'll go to Applications and then External, and I'll find the application inside of Rogue Master, and I'll go ahead and just use this version, which has been modified. A lot of times it's been fixed up and a little bit improved over the original. And about 80% of the apps run across different firmwares. Next, we need to clone the application code. We could clone that original GitHub, but in this case, I'll just go ahead and into Rogue Master and we'll clone theirs. Actually, instead of doing a get clone, let's just go ahead and say download zip, and that'll download our zip file and we can extract that. So we'll go into the firmware, we'll go into applications, external, and then we'll scroll down to the application that we want. Next, we'll go ahead and open our repo folder. We'll go into our firmware and applications user. And then we'll drag the files that we need into that folder. And then confirm that inside of there, we have all the subfolders and that this folder has our application.fam file. Now we're ready to build and deploy the app. So copy the command for either Kali or Windows. Paste it into your command window. Make sure the name you type matches what you put in applications user folder. Make sure your flipper's not running anything and that it's plugged in and that QFlipper's not running, and then go ahead and press enter. I'll bring up QFlipper and you can see the applications running on our flipper now. And we can go ahead and use the application, type in some text, hit save, and then we can scroll through the various ciphertexts. Next, let's look at some of the issues you may encounter when you're trying to deploy an app. The first one is loader is locked. This happens when you're already running an application on your flipper. Just press back a bunch of times or do back and left arrow to reboot the flipper, and that should be good. This next error can happen if you're running QFlipper or the CLI, or if you forgot to connect your flipper to the computer. It basically says I failed to find it. In that case, make sure that everything is shut down and that the cables are connected. Next, let's look at what happens if you had an older version of an application. So I'm going to go ahead and edit this application.fam file to simulate an older version where capital letters were allowed in the app ID. So go ahead and save that. So now we'll compile, and you can see that we're getting this purple warning, and it says invalid app ID. So if you get an error like this, you may have to change the app ID to use lowercase letters. And the last topic I wanted to cover was refreshing your firmware to the latest version. So go ahead and open a command terminal, cd into your repo, cd into your firmware, and then do a get pull, and this will pull all the latest. Once you've pulled all the latest code, check out the branch you want to use, such as release or dev. Back up your SD card, and then go ahead and run the FBT command to deploy the firmware to your Flipper Zero. Make sure your Flipper's plugged in. Make sure it's not running any applications. And if you get the kill signal terminated error, just go ahead and rerun the app. Now you know how to deploy custom firmware and custom applications onto your Flipper Zero. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below or leave it on my Discord server. In the description for this video, I'll leave a link to my wiki.